Music is good right now in Nigeria to me.
Okay. Now, Cash 11 is a music producer.
Yeah.
And you're an actor.
Yeah.
You're a model.
Yeah.
I mean, and you do hip-hop.
Yeah.
You have like a billion things in your hands.
I'm still discovering myself though.
Oh, tell us about it. You're being modest.
I can, tomorrow I can be the presenter.
You're welcome.
I can be maybe I'll be co-hosting the program with you.
That'll be good. I'll welcome
just
you.
Like, yeah, welcome to Sugar and Spice on NTA2. My name is Cash 11, and this is.
Is that how we do it? Yeah. Like you've put hip hop into it.
Yeah, I'm trying to spice up the.
Okay, now tell us the kind of song, the hip hop thing you do.
I do rap. I rap majorly. But sometimes I try to like do the singing aspect in a way.
Okay.
But it's basically rap. A rap.
The song, the chorus.
Yeah.
How did you come about that? Because I hear that song a lot.
Yeah. Last year, actually a lot of my fans, because I took a break after dropping my first album 2007,
okay.
Triple Twilight. And I took a long break. So a lot of my fans are just be like, hey, what's Cash 11 up to? What's this? What's that? The last thing, because I've been busy working.
That was studio. That wasn't Nigerian. It's American.
Yeah.
So I've been working.
Yeah. So okay. I've been like, oh, I've been working. So and I'll be like in this rap hip hop game, we do mixtapes. So like water my fans' appetite.
Okay.
Like made them now like, okay, cool down, just sticks. They just a little bit of me. I'm coming up, I'm cooking
okay.
something.
Okay.
I'm
I
cooking
get
something.
That.
So I now release a mixtape album.
Okay.
Jump on any song I feel
okay.
right is right. Then I'm trying to make it better.
Okay.
You know, jump on
but
the track.
You sort the right.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, definitely.
I have
MCS and people working okay. definitely the right is sought. Out for
okay,
you get before jumping
good.
On it.
You would know what I mean to say. Circumstance leaves me only waiting for the change.
He's always doing it differently. Not just differently, but in a very positive way.
I'm looking forward to watching a really good movie. I'm looking forward to having a lot of fun. Kunle is my friend. He's a director that I respect very much. I've worked with him in the past with The Figurine, and that movie went ahead to win a lot of awards. I won Best Actress Awards for that movie. So Kunle is someone I really respect. Now he's done another movie, so I know it's going to be the bomb. And I know I'm going to have a lot of fun today because this one is a comedy. So we're here to have fun.
Kunle is a tough director to work with because, you know, he put me through my paces. You know, I mean, I've been acting for a long time now, and I just felt that, okay, you know, I thought it might be a little bit, you know, not as difficult as some of my previous films, but Kunle was really, really hard on me, so I had to do even extra work, you know, to get the character right. And yeah, so yeah, it was hard work, to be honest. It's a bit difficult because I just come off filming a series called Meet the Adebanjos, which is on right now. So I was in comedy mode, you know. So I had to, and the character of Akin Cole is very serious, so I had to be very serious, you know. So it was a bit of a switch for me to be able to make that switch. So.
Oh, the part where those guys are the twins are asked what they do, and they say business. Business. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, there were so many challenges. I mean, you know, when you make film, you go through the challenge of raising funds, you go through the challenge of putting your cast and crew together, you go through the challenge of locations and all that. But we went through all that, but in the end, we scaled through, and the film is done.
Okay. Yeah. In respect to what you're going to do later, later, what kind of aid would you need? I mean, what would you need to make things better next time?
More money, so I don't have to keep running around. I should stay creative. I should think of creativity and not chasing money. All these things distract, but it's all good. It's all business, you know. Yeah, this one won't win Oscar, but our next film will win Oscar.
Within and outside Africa, who have converged to celebrate the African film industry.
Nollywood is like, is that woman that people want to compare to maybe another woman from Europe. So it takes a gradual process. We are seeing good things coming out from Nollywood, you understand? So Nollywood has come to stay. I mean, we are the children. We are the offspring of Nollywood, and it has come to stay. And we have been able to use Nollywood to tell the story of Nigeria, to tell our own story, to tell African stories.
Nollywood is growing by the day, because I won't say we started like this. So I would say today I'm very, very proud to be part of Nollywood, because in the past we have actually done some wishy-washy movies, but right now I'll tell you we are on top and we're going. We're doing good movies with good cameras, screenplays and everything, so we're getting there.
But this is an incredible event. You know, it's an incredible achievement to have 8 AMA Awards, like, already on board, a show that's already touted as the you know, the African Oscars. And for me to come back as a Nigerian with my new Nigerian name, Omobowale Adubaran, you know, I feel great. I feel incredible.
So. It has grown so much, and there's something very enigmatic about Nollywood, but what I'm understanding is that for me, as an American, with all the pressure that you have for a box office release, that it's got to be, that Nollywood allows filmmakers to make a movie that they want to make without the pressure of having to have big box office on opening night or something like that. So the people are actually able to express themselves. And the fact that so many filmmakers are able to do it, and there's so many films being made a year, I think the rest of the world should look at it. And by example, you know, I would love for African-American filmmakers to be able to do the same. It's very exciting right now.
It's an eye-opener, you know, it's really an eye-opener. Because all the awards they have been doing before AMA started, they were just concentrating on Nigerian actors and all the rest of them. But this one has gone a little bit away from that normal way of doing awards. You know, they are doing great by inviting other artists too. by looking into their films, because if not for AMA, I don't even know that they do films in other African countries, because we don't get to see them and watch them, except for Indian films that we were used to, you know, since time immemorial. But the one that AMA is doing now, they have really helped us, you know, to put us together to make sure that to let us know that it is not only in Nigeria that they do movies, that other countries are doing movies and they are doing great too, you know, because if you watch their movies too, you will know that they are doing great.
The African Movie Academy Awards 2012 had winners from 26 categories nominated. Beside the glitz and glamour characterized by the event, winners say hard work and dedication are key factors to moving the entertainment industry forward.
I am really happy. I feel good. I feel rewarded for, you know, for a job that I put in so much work for.
It's a great thing to have this in my hands now. This means the greatest task. This means the challenge. This means it just got tougher. This means all eyes on me now. Anything I do that is below the line, I'll be in the spotlight.
I know where I'm coming from. I know how hard I've worked to get here. And to see that it's starting to pay is just really, really emotional, honestly.
Peace Anyam Osigwe, founder African Movie Academy Awards, say African filmmakers must begin to embrace creativity to promote African indigenous works.
I'm trying to make sure that we push African cinema to the next level, and I'm hoping that by the time we're just growing, I'm still a toddler, and I'm hoping that we get more support to promote it.
The event featured Two-Faced Dibia, Asha, Vivian Chidid of Senegal, who thrilled the guests with their performances.
Did you choose to sing in Yoruba?
For some time I've been in Lagos, and I've always loved the whole Oremi word, because in school, back then in Apsu, all the Lagosians were always like, Oremi, what's up today now? So it just got to me like, okay, Oremi is fit for friendship in
my
head.
Okay, that's really good. What inspired that song and the video?
What inspired the song? It was weddings, basically. Okay. I used to write for a wedding magazine called NotMyWedding.com. So
okay.
I reflected back to how marriages used to be. And I said to myself, okay, let me write something about love, and then let me concentrate on the best part of love, which is the union of a man and a woman. So I thought of Oremi, and I said, okay, let me sing about friendship, because I believe that's what keeps marriages. Because after love, the attraction, the money, everything fades except the friendship. So I said, okay, let me project friendship in marriage and see how it goes. And it's been getting...
I'm so impressed with your work.
Thank you.
You know, usually they feel, okay, she didn't come out tops, which means I'll just forget about her. You know, but like with your position, number 5, you're doing this and you're doing much more. But I'd like you to like tell us what it was like in the house then.
It was challenging. It was a great experience. At first I was elated. I mean, like really, really excited to have, you know, gone through from 6,000 to 3,000 to 1,000 to 500 and then to top 6, top 10. You know, it was really amazing. And I felt privileged. I felt people believed in me for them to have voted me in. So I said to myself, okay, let me make people proud of me. It wasn't really about me anymore. And, you know, along the way, we learned a lot of things, voice coaching, met a lot of good people, people wanted to encourage in the industry. And I think it was an eye-opener at the end of the day, because now I know when... I know some parts in the industry whereby I shouldn't do this, I shouldn't, you know, burn bridges, you know. I think we've been taught that in the house. So it's actually made me a wiser person and a stronger person, because the music industry is not for the feeble-minded, I think. It's for the strong and the passionate that wants to stay in it, so you have to stay put. So I think that's what the whole grooming, the whole boot camp thing did to me. It made me a stronger, wiser person.
Okay, that's good. I'm going to call for that musical video again, but I want you to tell us now, you're coming into the Nigerian music industry. Okay. It's a place that is full of talent, beautiful people, with a swaggering, defining us, according to Omoba in his music, for swagger, defined us. I like that, and I like Omoba especially, you know? So everybody says, you know, different things like that. But for you, what exactly are you coming in with?
I'm coming with good lyrics. I think, you know, Then in the olden days, our parents used to love to sing our lyrics because love was like everything. Okay. Like, I love you, I can do this for you. The lyrics actually powered the songs, not the beats powering the music. I think that's what I'm trying to like redefine.
You did a gospel song also.
Yes, I did. It's titled Your Love, Jesus.
Okay.
Yeah, I wanted my first song to be for God.
Okay.
I wanted to be like, oh yes, God, thank you for taking me through the musical, everything. And like, to show my loyalty.
Okay.
God, I love you. This is like a tribute to you, to thank you for, you know, giving me such a great gift. So okay. That's why I did the song to him. Okay. It's talking about his love that is endless. You know, when I go wrong, his love is not shy. Neither okay. is it proud. So. Okay. That actually got to me. I mean, you could be in a relationship where a guy, you know, gets tired of you. He never gets tired of us. So
yeah.
That's just awesome.
That is.